Assalamu alaikum and good morning to all my dear students, class 12, business study. Students, from last many lectures, you are watching this chapter, very important chapter, marketing, part 2, business study, chapter number 1. Students, we are discussing the functions of marketing. Now, functions of marketing. Okay, students. We have discussed different functions of marketing. We have seen labeling, we have seen packing, we have seen distribution of product, we have seen many other aspects which is related to marketing. 9 to 10 functions we have already discussed. Now still students, 3 very important functions, remaining functions that we are going to discuss today. Total 12 functions are there, 9 we have already discussed in last few lectures. Now today we are going to discuss next 3 and the last 3 functions of marketing. The one is physical distribution. Now students, physical distribution of product, that means what? That product is ready in the godown or product is ready there in the factory. So from factory to customer, we have to dispatch the product. So how we can dispatch the product from factory to customer? So different options are there. Students, customers are scattered. It means that customers are spread at different places. And some of the businesses have their customers nearby area, whereas some of the businesses have their customers all around the country, all around the world also. So how to just send the product from company to customer, different mode of options that we have. So students, first physical distribution of the product, there we are going to discuss the channels. So first one is the zero level channel. Now what is zero level channel? That is from manufacturer to directly customer. So no one is there in between. Manufacturer to directly customer. Students, what is the meaning of manufacturer to customer? Company make the product and company directly send it to the customer without using any middle person. The benefit of this thing is that in middle there is no one. So the product will be cheap because that company will take the profit and directly give to the customer. So in between there is no one. So profit margin will not increase, because if someone is there in between, then those people will also take their own profit. So profit will be there added in the cost of the product. So the price of the product will also go high. But here, because directly company to customer is there, it means that in the middle there is no one. So the price of the product will remain stable. Okay. Now this is only possible for the company if the customers are limited also, as well as customers are in nearby area. If the customers are in high quantity, as well as customers are living far distance, then this is not possible, just because one company cannot reach to different places. So here, company to customer, zero level channel is there. Then you can say one level channel. Now one level means what? Manufacturer, then retailer, and then customer. This is also possible. Manufacturer means company, retailer means those people who purchase from company in a big quantity and they sell in a small quantity to the customers. So retailers will be there and then customers will be there. Students, this is only required when the customers are in large quantity also, as well as the customers are living at different far distance also. Okay, but the thing is what? Here the price of the product will little bit more, will go high, just because that company made the product. Suppose company made the product of 100 rupees, company will get 10% profit, so 110 will be here. Now it will go to retailer, so retailer 110 already there. plus the retailer will also add his own 10 rupees. So it will be 120. So it reaches to the customer in 120 rupees. This is the difference. Here what happened in this 100 rupees product is there, 10 rupees profit will be there. So 110 directly go to customer in 110. So here the product price is 110, whereas here 120, just because that here retailers are there. But the good thing here is that customers will get the product nearby their area. Here one problem may be that customer may have to travel to far distance to purchase the product, whereas here customer may not have to travel too long to purchase the product. Now the second is two level channel. Now two level channel means what? Manufacturer will be there. Okay, now comes wholesaler, then comes retailer, and then comes customer. So this is what we have. These two people are there in between. Manufacturer is there, customer is there, but in between that wholesaler and retailer. Now wholesaler means what? That they purchase from company in a large quantity, huge quantity. They sell it to the retailer in a reasonably small quantity. And retailer will sell to customer in a very small quantity in single unit also. The thing is what? This system can be used where the business is spread in entire state or country or even worldwide also. So this can be used. If the business is having a small size, I believe that either one zero level channel or one level channel is accepted. If the business is having a large scale business, then large scale industries I should say, then this may be more useful. But the problem as we have discussed earlier, 100 rupees price, 10 rupees profit of this person, so 110 will be there. Now these people will purchase in 110, they will add their profit, maybe 10% is example I am making. So 120 will be here, these people will be here, 120, they will add their profit, so 130, so customer ultimately will get 130. The more the channels are there, the price of the product will go high. You look here, zero level channel, only 110 rupees are there, one level channel, 120 rupees are there, two level channels, 130 rupees are there. So this is what I mean to say. Second thing I would like to say, students, here it will take little bit more long time from company to customer to reach the product because no one is there. Here probably the time limit is little bit less compared to this one, because here the middle people are there, so they will always keep the product ready to give you, means customers. Here the delivery will be the fastest, just because that these people, wholesaler, already have the products with them, and they give it to the retailer. Retailer also keeps some products with them, and then customers anytime, whenever they want, immediately go to nearby retailer shop and they can purchase the product. So this is also there two level. Even D level channel is also there, students. Now three level channel, I'll explain it here. Manufacturer is always there, obviously. Manufacturer is there, then comes second one is the wholesaler, then comes retailer, then comes franchisees may be there, then maybe even contractors may be there, okay? So many people, and then comes customers. So students, what happens sometimes, if the company, something example I'll give you, franchisees means what? Students, McDonald's is a huge, I can say that business in entire world, KFC is a huge business. So what they people do, suppose like McDonald's is in America right now and they want to sell the product in India. In India also so many McDonald's are there, outlets are there. So in India, what they do, they allow someone to use the name of the McDonald's. Someone, a person, purchase the franchisee, or you can say the dealership. Dealership is little different compared to franchisee. But McDonald's, we are talking about franchisee right now. Franchisee means the using of the name of that McDonald's. That is what And here in many places you can see the McDonald. But that person who is there in America, the boss of McDonald, will not come to India to that particular outlet to sell the products. Okay, what they do, that person do? They open their own outlets in different parts, and then they give the right to someone to continue that business. So that is what franchising we are talking about. Even dealership also, you can see students, Pepsi is there, Coke is there. So these are the poultry brands are there, where company boss or one company or one place, they cannot dispatch the product to different places, because poultry is right now, it is everywhere, in villages also, in the cities also. So just to avail the product to different people, what the company will do, they give the dealership to someone. Now what is the difference between dealership and then this franchising? Franchising means using the name of someone, whereas dealership means that that same person is the boss, just giving the right to sell the product. So that is the difference. So students, even this channel is also used, three-level channel. Mostly it has been used by the international companies. This is mostly used by three-level channel will be used by you can say multinational businesses or international companies, where they have the customers in all around the world. So student, this is what we have, physical distribution. That means that how to send the product or how the product is available to different people. Zero level channel, one level channel, two level channel, and then three level channels are there. Now it depends on the company that first of all, company will do the survey. They will analyze that where their customers are scattered or where their customers residing at present. If the customers are in nearby area, they may go for less channels. They may go for zero level or one level channel. But if their customers are at different far distance, they may go for two level channel also. And if the multinational business is there, then even the three level channel will also be used. Students, proper use of channel is very important, because if you make the mistake in selection of the channel to distribute your product, to sell your product, to avail your product in the market, then a business may not get 100% success. The important is that customers right nowadays cannot wait for a long time. And very more important here right now, students, that now from last maybe around 5 to 6 years, the online business has taken a place and almost covered 70-80% of the international market right now. So suppose if you are late in just dispatching the product to the customers, customers will not wait for you. They will move themselves to another company and they can purchase from there also. So students, you should be more alert, more effective, more efficient while sending your product to the customers. It should be time bound, quality should also be maintained, quantity should also be maintained, as well as all the other necessary requirements should be fulfilled. So this is what physical distribution is there in front of you. My humble request, you please copy this right now. Now after physical distribution, students, we are going to discuss the next second last topic. Physical distribution ke baad ki baat kar raha hu. The next topic we are going to discuss right now is transportation. This point is over. Now we are discussing the transportation. Now students, what is transportation? I don't think it is fair to say you, because you already have seen all this in 11th standard and even before that also. Transportation means the use of vehicles to, from manufacturer, from company to customers, to market. Which vehicles you are using, which transportation mode you are using just to dispatch your product from one place to another place. Now students, it's a quite common sense. If the distance is nearby area, you can use the simple vehicles. But if your business is spreaded in entire country, you may go for the other option like trains, goods trains are there, you can use that. Or heavy trucks, you can use that also. And if your business is international business, then you can use the marine way also, sea also, I mean to say steamers are there. And you can use the aeroplane also, flights I can say that. So I mean to say that it depends on where your business is right now. If your business is just between Bharuch and Ankleshwar, then you can go for a simple mode of vehicles like tempo, maybe there, truck, maybe there. But if your business is maybe from Bharuch to Kerala, then okay, trucks are also option, but goods train also you can use that. If your business is spreaded from India to America, India to Japan, India to Canada or any other country, then you may go for the marine way also, you may go for the airways also. So this is what transportation plays an important role. But the thing is, what transportation cost also you have to keep in mind, because ultimately transportation cost is added to the cost of the product. So once you are using the transportation mode, please keep in mind various aspects like the distance also, cost also, as well as the time limit also. Students, transportation is not a difficult thing. I think we'll continue about transportation also, and the last topic is warehouse, that we will discuss definitely now in the next lecture. Today's our main and center point was the physical distribution of the product. I hope you got it. We'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you very much.